Did you know that in BIM 360, you can do automatic clash detection? The clash coordination has never been easier, and if you are not using this module, you're missing a lot. Imagine how much clashes you would have solved, and you would coordinate it more efficiently with all the consultants, but just using this model, which is automatic clash coordination. You need to activate this model coordination, or your admin has to activate it, and make sure that you use consume workflow to get most out of it. And here I can see a matrix. If you can navigate to the clashes, you can see the matrix. And if I just click on the clashes, like I see five clashes here versus one model another, I'm actually seeing that the both models are not perfectly aligned. So make sure that you are using shared coordinates to efficiently able to coordinate and detect the clashes automatically. So I'm here, I'm going to enable share the latest updated version of the shared coordinates. This way my clashes will be updated as well, and my models will be matching and they will be overridden right away. It just took under 1 minute in order to update all the clashes for this model. Obviously this model is very small, so if it's a little larger model, it might take a little longer, but here you are. If I click on the clashes, I can see all the 92 clashes right in front of me. And all these clashes, since they are available, I can categorize them. That's the most beautiful part of it. I can say by object, which is lots of clashes, but I can also say by level. So if I just write level, and I can just say base level. So here you can see that level one living room, level two, and there are no constraints, and this is saying ceiling. Most probably there's another level called ceiling. And I can also categorize them in different categories. So I can see all the issues on level one, and there will be all of them directly visible to me, and I can see them where they are located exactly with a single click. And what I prefer doing here is a one trick that just makes sure that clashes are about 1 inches or maybe like even more, depending on how you want to analyze it. So 1 inch is practically a good option. And once you have, you can see that the amount of clashes have decreased significantly. And here I can see what are all the issues where my strayer case is overlapping with the beams and the columns. So all these are visible right in front of me. If you navigate to the model browser on the left side, here you can actually see all the components by discipline, assembly, category, family, or type. That's excellent because I can just hide both structural and architectural model, and I can just see all the floors of architectural, all the walls of architectural, and I can also see just the particular families like bar chair and like where they are located. Now, basic roof, I can just see those basic roofs. I can see anything I want within a few clicks, and it will filter everything I need in seconds. So this is an excellent tool for clash coordination, and it does automatic clashes. It detects them and it allows you to work on them. If you want to learn more about how to take those clashes and convert them into issues, follow up in the next video. If you need help setting these kind of automated workflows, please visit our website. We'll be more than happy to help you to set up all the automations that will save you tons of time. If you want to know how to take these clashes into issues, where instead of sending emails or screenshots, where you can collaborate in a kind of a ticketing way, where you can track all these issues and make sure that they are being solved, and all the communication can be kept by issue-based, please follow the next video where you can see how you can do it. Our goal is to save over 20% in production for architects. If you want automations, if you want AI, if you want to speed up, if you want to have the best workflows, that is the best practice available for your team, please get in touch with us. We'll be more than happy to help you.